Yeah, thank you. This is a notice of the purpose of this meeting today. For the purpose of considering how to preserve and defend the Constitution of the United States and the state of North Carolina relating to the right to bear arms, the inability of the U.S. Congress to control spending, the issue of immigration, and other state and federal matters relating to the welfare of the people. And the motion that I would propose, Mr. Deathridge has, and I propose it in the form of a motion, and I think that if, with your permission, he will read it.
Yes, and I'll second that motion, and with that second, my first comments would be to read this.
Yes, sir. Please read it.
A resolution to preserve and defend the Constitution of the United States and the state of North Carolina. Whereas the Constitution of the United States provides a well-regulated militia being necessary to the security of a free state, the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed, the Second Amendment. And whereas the Constitution of the state of North Carolina provides a well-regulated militia being necessary to the security of a free state, the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. And as standing armies in time of peace are dangerous to liberty, they shall not be maintained, and the military shall not be kept under strict subordination to and governed by the civil power. Nothing herein shall justify the practice of carrying concealed weapons or prevent the General Assembly from enacting penal statutes against that practice. Article 1, Section 30. And whereas the Constitution, whereas the United States Supreme Court in recent months has twice upheld the Second Amendment as applying to individuals' rights to keep and bear arms, and the President and the Vice President of the United States have been reported recently to be considering adopting laws, regulations, or actions which would have the effect of infringing on the right of Americans to keep and bear arms. And whereas the reasons given in support of such infringements as gun registration, banning certain kinds of weapons and accessories, requiring extreme background checks, restricting the bearing of arms, such as excessive restrictions on concealed carry and possible other restrictions, have not been shown by substantial weight of scientific evidence to have been effective in accomplishing the stated objectives of such restrictions as compelling necessities for government action to protect the public safety. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Beaufort County Board of Commissioners, sitting in duly called session on this day, that the Beaufort County Board of Commissioners calls upon the Governor and the General Assembly of the State of North Carolina to immediately pass an act to nullify the implementation of any federal law, executive order, or regulations restricting the right to keep and bear arms, and be it further resolved, the county manager be directed to see that no county paid staff participate in nor allow any county resources be used in the implementation of any federal law, executive order, or executive directive that infringe on the right to keep and bear arms, and be it further resolved that the General Assembly is petitioned to take the appropriate action to have a constitutional convention called upon a concurrence by two-thirds of the state legislatures for the specific purpose of amending the United States Constitution to strengthening to Second and Tenth Amendments as applicable against federal infringement of the inalienable right of the people to keep and bear arms and prohibit infringement by the federal government in the state's rights to guarantee the protection of the right to keep and bear arms, and be it further resolved that the General Assembly adopt a proposed amendment to the North Carolina Constitution to be submitted to voters to change Article 1, Section 30, to guarantee the right of a law-abiding citizen to carry unimpeded a concealed weapon in any place that a duly sworn law enforcement officer may carry a weapon, and that any law passed by the General Assembly or imposed by any executive official restricting the right to keep and bear arms be subject to the strictest judicial scrutiny if challenged as infringing on the right to keep and bear arms, and be it further resolved that this resolution, properly enacted and executed, this, the 18th day of January 2013, be transmitted to the Clerk of the Senate and the House of Representatives of the North Carolina General Assembly, the Governor, and each member of the General Assembly, as well as to each county commission in the state of North Carolina, and to the North Carolina Association of County Commissioners, and to the public.
Thank you, Stan. As the person who made the motion, you have the opportunity and the authority to speak on the topic first, if you so choose.
Well, thank you very much. Of course, we could talk on this a long time, and I don't intend to do that. I intend to vote for this resolution calling constitutional conventions simply because the Constitution of the United States has been stretched to its limits. It has been abused during the past 10 to 20 years, to say nothing of the last three or four, and it is the one way, it is the tool that was given to the public by the framers of the Constitution to call rogue, renegade, bad governments into line. We need a constitutional convention to let them know that the people are actually in charge and not the boys in Washington, D.C. who are doing the deals and swapping the bucks around.
I'm prepared. In support of what Commissioner Richardson is saying, I wrote a prepared statement, and I shall read it now. Founding Father Thomas Jefferson, America's third president and chief author of the Declaration of Independence, once remarked, "The tree of liberty must be refreshed from time to time with the blood of patriots and tyrants. It is its natural manure." Now, this most prophetic statement may mean different things to many people, but I know what it means to me. To me, Thomas Jefferson, well remembered and oft-quoted maxim expresses, "Americans then and now should remain vigilant and always be prepared to no sacrifice." Moreover, while remaining vigilant, the greatest tool to achieve the watchful eye of a true patriot, prepared to know the sacrifice that Founder Jefferson speaks of, is knowledge. Knowledge to observe and know the signs of that terrible danger to the Republic that awaits just around the bend. And the knowledge to know that there are tools prescribed to defend the Republic, to keep it sound, to keep us safe. Chief among these well-considered tools is that of a called constitutional convention, which has wide support and wide implications as to whether it could even be successful in achieving the desired effect of bringing us all closer to the full and firm intent of our founders. To successfully call and complete a constitutional convention to the benefit of our nation begs for a great responsibility in our collective citizenship, but it is a chance I am willing to take. As our nation falls uncontrollably into an abyss of debt, as many of our elected leaders diligently concern themselves with the ever-present function of their constituent duties for the betterment of their reelection, our republic teeters on the edge of an American oblivion. I'm not willing to chance the dire outcome as our eventual reality. I beg that we act now to preserve and protect the liberty that Thomas Jefferson spoke of, the sacrifice that will ensure sustainability as a continued republic for us and for our children.
Thank you, Mr. Duffy. Mr. Brim, do you have anything to say?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
I recognize you.
I appreciate the opportunity to participate in this motion that I'm going to support. Former Democratic Vice President Walter Mondale got it right when he said this: guns do not disarm criminals. Gun bans attract them. Today we need a nation of Minutemen, citizens who are not only prepared to take arms, but citizens who regard the privilege of freedom and the basic purpose of their daily lives and are willing to consciously work and sacrifice for freedom. President John F. Kennedy. Our founders understood how important it was for citizens to have the same weaponry as military. The citizens are the counter to government out of control. That was their reason. In Switzerland, the law requires every male over 18 years old to have a fully automatic weapon. In World War II, Hitler and the Nazis attack many nations in Europe except one, Switzerland. I wonder why. You can't have genocide without having gun control. I was once told by a military officer who attended the General Staff Training School during the Cold War, the main reason why the Soviet Union never attacked us on our own soil was not because of our military, because they knew that they could not overcome our nation's citizens who were armed and could protect their own selves. When I took the oath of office joining the Army and the oath that I took here in this room for my office, I swore to support and defend the Constitution of the United States, including the Second Amendment, and I will do that. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I firmly agree with what each of the other commissioners has said. And I firmly support this resolution. I firmly support the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of North Carolina. And I absolutely firmly defend our Second Amendment rights and our Tenth Amendment rights. I defend the Constitution completely. Nowadays, it seems like the Constitution is under constant attack. We have these executive orders being issued by the President going after their Second Amendment rights when they should really be going through Congress. It's unlawful, in my opinion. And I think it's time for all people in all counties to raise up and adopt resolutions similar to this. And saying that, I call the question.
I have one more statement.
One more comment, please do.
My opinion on the Second Amendment is very strict, as it was written to be so. We've seen politicians who probably don't understand the Constitution as well as they should, ranting and raving about how you don't need more than 10 rounds to hunt. The Second Amendment is not about hunting. It's about protection. It's about protecting our families. It's about protecting our homeland. It's about protecting the Constitution itself from tyrants and enemies, domestic and foreign. And it's our right to call for a constitutional convention to strengthen our Constitution. And I hope that there will be other politicians that will rise forward, speaking to you people at a grassroots level who wish and know that this needs to be done. And I pray that our nation will sustain itself by the sacrifice of us now. Thank you.
Commissioner Brim or Commissioner Richardson, would you also like to make a short
statement? I have no further comments.
Okay. I hereby call the question. All those in favor of the motion, raise their hand.
Bless you.
I would like to make one comment. This is a 4-0 vote, but there are three commissioners not here today, and they have not been released from not being here, and their votes are in the affirmative. So we have a majority of seven commissioners.
Mr. Commissioner, let me correct you.
Republicans and three Democrats, just a moment, who are voting here today to do as we're doing now. Yes.
Those members who are not present or absent, their votes will not be affirmative. Only the four members present, if one fails to vote, this is according to your bylaws, your procedure. If any member present fails to vote, it will be affirmative. Yes. But an absent member who is not present will not be. He's not. He can't.
So it is just a majority vote. It is a unanimous vote.
Four members of the commission, which is a majority out of seven.
What about the state law in the case of absences like this?
Well, we've got our rules here. And I think under the state law, we'll have to research that. If it's something that you think.
I think we need to research.
I don't believe
the state
you're
law.
Going. You're not going to be able to record an absent member who is not in attendance as being a voting member. He's not present. He's simply absent. He can't vote.
Randall,
he was negative or affirmative.
Randall, have Bill research that.
We can look that up if you want to.
We'll do that.
Appreciate it. We need to have that.
Can I amend what I said to one thing?
Yes, sir.
If our registered Democrats, who cannot be here today with us in body, hopefully they're here with us in spirit, and their votes will be for the Constitution and for America.
Thank you. Motion to adjourn.
Well, let me do one thing before we adjourn, if I may, Mr. Chairman. We would like this resolution sent to the Association of County Commissioners to all of the 100 counties in the state of North Carolina, and anybody else that wants it, the Senate, all of the senators, and all of the House members.
Would you please send it to the President of the United States?
Yes, to President Obama.
No, sir, we're not taking any comments.
We can't have comments from the public.
I had a question, actually.
No questions.
Yes. I move we adjourn.
Second. Meeting is adjourned. Now you can, thank you.